Good day, beautiful people. Today we will be learning about Almighty Resistor, which we can see here. It is the true hole version. I hope the camera is zooming well. Resistor, it is bidirectional element. The symbol for it, if you live in Europe, a little puny box. But no, the superior element. This is the little box. This is resistor. See, box around it. But if you live in America, then the symbol is like so. Lines and more lines. If you ask me, this symbol is superior. None of this rubbish. European rubbish no good in this case. Unless you live in Europe, then use this. Resistor is bidirectional element, meaning electricity flow left to right and right to left. It no matter. Electricity always flow as long as you connect plus and minus. To show you how to use resistor, I will need multimeter. But not this little multimeter. No, no. We need big multimeter. Because if we use big multimeter, then bigger is always better. Yes. But we need ohmic region symbol for the almighty ohm. You set it like so. You are smart. You will be able to figure out. I am sure. So, this is multimeter screen, and this is your best friend, the breadboard. No, you cannot cut bread on it, but you can use it to learn electronics. And this is the power button. You click it, and power come on. It is incredible, I know. One just means it out of range. No important. Soon enough, it will be in range. This, as you can see, the resistor has bands. As you cannot see, because the camera is not in focus. But now you can see. You can see, if you are not colorblind, that there are bands. Oh, multiple bands. There is brown. There is black, another black, then red, then brown, but brown not important. We want to know brown, black, red. Yes, red, brown, black, red. These resistor color codes, very important. As you can see here, as an example, brown, black, red means 1002. 1002 means if I could zoom 1002, this mean 1002. No, it no mean. It mean 102 zeros. So the third band always mean number of zeros. So we get 10,000. The value of our resistor is around 10,000. Very good. Now, if we want to measure resistance, we use hand and multimeter probe. Since resistor is bidirectional, we can switch hand no problem. Now, you hold resistor like so or like so, it no matter. Watch multimeter, it will show truth. You connect multimeter, you can connect with hand, no problem, and touch. Here you can see, it is set to kilo, K for kilo. Yes, 20 kilo range, it show around 10. That mean our resistor 10 kilo ohm. Kilo means 1000. So, our resistor 10 kilo, And I have its brother, another 10 kilo. And if we measure, we get same value, around 10 kilo, which will be okay for our example. So put them here, no problem. I mess around and cut video, so you see magic. Ah, magic, I told you. Paper now clean, magic, like electronics, basically magic. So, a little bit of theory. You need to obey the law. You are good law-abiding citizen, nevertheless. The law for today is you are I. That means voltage. You can also write V for voltage, but I write U because U, smoother, sexier letter. R means resistance, and I is current. So, the units are, in brackets, amps. But we will probably mostly use milliamps, because we do not want to kill ourselves. Not just yet. Resistance. This sexy Greek letter, it means ohms. So this is Ohm's law. Ohm's law is not British name, like Ernest, but it is Ohm's law, because it is a law, and you must obey the law. And voltage. As I said, you can write V, but V is the unit, volts. So volts are ohms times current. Very simple, very basic law. You need to remember the law. All of electronics obeys this law, I think. So, as I say, this is what we will be using as symbol for a resistor. But you also need a symbol for battery. This is symbol for battery. This is plus. And this is minus. No battery like beating your wife or anything, but battery like active energy battery. 9 volts. Super alkaline. We today, because I am expert, we will be using power supply, which is superior. I will show you how to make in separate video. But for today, we make simple circuit. First, I explain. To make simple circuit, you need to know that voltage flows from plus to minus. So, if we have battery, I will write plus and minus, but you do not need to. Because you smart and you know it plus and minus because of long and short line. That's how your beautiful mind work. So, we put in circuit a resistor. Then we connect the circuit, because if there is no connection, no current can flow and there is no voltage passing through it. So now we connect circuit. So here is battery, let's say 9 volt battery. The current flows this way. Ah, notice the smudge. This is not supposed to be here. This is added bonus, just for you. So, here we have resistor. It does not matter which value it is. Let's say 10 ohm. Or it can be even be 10,000 ohm. No matter. In this example, voltage here is 9 volts, because voltage always drop on resistor. But if there is no resistor yet, voltage has not dropped. So, at plus of battery, you get 9 volts. But at minus of battery, you have to have 0 volts, because battery is basically a difference of voltages. So, you have 0 volts here, and 9 volts here. You always have 0 volts at minus of battery, and always have the rated voltage at plus of battery. So, the voltage drops across resistor. So here is 9 volts, but voltage drops to 0 volts. So here is also 0 volts. And here is also 0 volts. Here is smudge, but if this was measuring test point, it would also be 0 volts. And here is also 0 volts. But here, no, no 0 volts. Here we have 9 volts. This is just arrow pointing, do not mind it. So, now we know, voltage across resistor falls. But what happens if we have two resistor? Oh, smart question. I am glad I asked it. So here, we have first resistor like here. But then, we have another resistor. What do we do now? What happens? Here, as I said, we always have 0 volts. So 0 volts is here. But here, at plus terminal, there is 10 volts. Let's say 10 volts, not 9. Because 10 is pretty number. If we have 10 ohm here, and 10 ohm here. Easy to calculate. Yes. Our beautiful mind can calculate. No problem. If we have 10 volts here, then half of the voltage falls over the 10 ohm resistor. And the other half falls on the other resistor. Because 10 and 10 is 20. Ah, yes, 10 and 10, 20. No problem. All the voltage needs to get eaten up and be zero at the 9 volts. So here, you guessed it or calculated using calculator. Here we have 10 volts first, half of the voltage here, so 5 volts, and here is 0 volts. This is how you calculate. But this is easy. We do not need calculator for this. Or beautiful mind, if you have it. But, if you want to calculate, say, a 5 volt circuit. I will draw quickly. This is also resistor. Poorly drawn, but nevertheless resistor. As long as you know what you are doing, it is not a problem. This, let's say, it input voltage. U in. This will be voltage middle. UM. M for mama. Or middle, in this case. This is M. Sorry for my bad handwriting. I am doing my best. Let us say, resistor now 5 ohms. And this one, this is its big brother. It's 10 ohms. What do we do now? For this, we move the paper so you can see formula. Very important important formula. U middle, UM, yes, not mama but middle, is input voltage because everything starts with input voltage. No matter what voltage is, let's say 10 volts times, since all of voltage fall across two resistors, we want to know how much voltage gets eaten up on the first resistor. So we say times R1. Yes, that is what we do. But now, since other voltage fall on other resistor, we also need to divide. So we divide by all of the voltage. So we divide by all of the resistance. So R1 plus R2. I know you understand this. You are smart. So we have, if you want it like this, U in or U out. Haha, I make joke. No, U in times, oh, I make that for times, R1. divided by R1 plus R2. So, all of the resistance at the bottom and on top we have the partial resistance. So now we know. In our example, we can use U in 10 volts. So, U in is 10 volts times R1 is 5 volts, I mean 5 ohms, divided by 5 ohms plus 10 ohms. And my superior mind has calculated this instantly. It is 3.3 and then a bunch of threes. Volts. Never forget the volt. You need to know which unit you use. So 3.3 volts. But enough theory. Using this formula, we will now show example. This is example. As you can remember, this is breadboard. And this is almighty wire for connecting to breadboard. I will show how to use in separate video, but for today I will just use, it's no complicate. So now we use our friend multimeter. It has turned off, but no problem, we put on power again and we switch to volt. 20 volt range, okay, is no problem for this. I have set voltage to 10 because 10 volts is easy to calculate. See, 10 volts, as I said. Oh, it's not 10 volts, it's 3.6. Not great, not terrible. But I will switch to 10 volts because this is example. So it's easy to calculate. I am not using my brain power to switch voltage. No. Sadly, no. I would like to have this ability, but sadly, no. I am using my hand and power supply. I call it my hand power supply. See, 10 volts. Marvelous. So, we have 10 volts as U in. Or you out. Haha, I make joke again. So, see, now it shows zero because nothing is connected. If I plug in, then it shows 10 volts. But if not, then no current is flowing, there is no voltage. No voltage, voltage. No voltage, voltage. We make circuit with multimeter. This is your first circuit, you not make alone, but it is circuit you have at home. Or at least proper man should have at home. Or woman. It is 2020, nevertheless. So now, no voltage flows, but we can connect minus of power supply to orange and white. Normally this would be black, but you can understand. You can see black here. So you know, this is the minus, or 0 volts. Now, we connect 10 volt to plus, or orange, which normally is red. And you need to be careful, so these two wires do not touch. It is okay if plastic touches, but not metal. Metal go stuff, go boom. Don't touch metal. So now, we have our setup. 10 volts in the input, and now we use our friend resistor again. If the camera would zoom, that would be great. Thank you, camera. A resistor has leads. Leads are what we call wires sticking out of resistor. You can bend because you are strong. Now, see these holes. These holes mighty, they connected together, but not this way, only this way. So, if we plug in 10k resistor here, there is no circuit because plus and minus is not connected. See, line 10 and line 20, I mean column 10 and column 20 is now connected. But not column 15 and column 20. For this we need another resistor. See, new resistor. Now current can flow. As you can see, it is now connected. We have this red wire, which is 10 volts. Resistor 1. We will connect probe here, so we can measure if I lied. Maybe I lie, maybe this video fake, like Loch Ness Monster or Santa. Here is resistor 2. Not 1, I almost write 1. I meant 2, resistor 2 here. Yes. Here is red lead. I've write red, but it is orange in video. But you understand, you smart people. So, red is 10 volts. Resistor 1, resistor 2, and white or black, as it should be. But I am lazy, I no pick correct colors for wires. So here, there is 10 volts. In the middle, there is mystery volts. But if you have been paying attention, you already know. Here, you can see, we already did calculation. 10 volt, first resistor, second resistor, 0 volt. And 5 volt in middle. So now, we now use big multimeter. Because I already set up little tiny multimeter for video. And I make probe, so we can connect. It has better specifications. You can buy from AliExpress. It's good, I recommend. Of course, size is not important, like my girlfriend always tells me. I still prefer the big one. But this one easier to show, and coincidentally it have better specifications. You can get it off of AliExpress. It won't be fast, so you can get it off of Ali. But it's automatic, so we set it to voltage range, V for voltage or victory, but in this case is voltage. We plug in red wire or red probe, which is in this case is blue and white. Because why not? We smart, we know what we're doing. We connect red probe to middle point. But multimeter show zero. Or jumping around, but still zero. Maybe it better if I turn on light. No, it's not better. It's much worse. So, it jumping around. But it just mean it good multimeter. It basically zero. But why is it zero? In the middle, there should be 5 volts. No, you forget. Or maybe you not forget. Maybe you smart. We need to connect everything. Because voltage and current travel in circle. Connected circle. So we need to connect the minus to the black probe. Then, like magic, if nothing blows up, we get 5 volts. And as you can see, more or less 5 volt. Perfect. And if we lower voltage, we get lower. See? You can calculate 3 point. Let me just set it to 6, because I mentioned earlier, it's a beautiful number. Let us say 3.6. You can pause the video and calculate with superior brain power what the input voltage is. Pause the video now and comment below what voltage will be. Do it now. That was my poor Arnold Schwarzenegger impression. Haha, I make joke. I use pliers. Burned because I burn stuff in my spare time. But I use pliers to get wire out. So now, to measure input voltage, I need blue wire connected to minus, or black wire, black probe connected to minus, and red probe connected to start. Now we connect and see starting voltage 7.2. Were you correct? Comment below and like video if you were correct. For today, that is all. Thank you, and I will see you next time.